Hello everyone, welcome back to PGA Chen Design Channel. This channel is about sharing Rhino 3D knowledge to students and professionals, learning various Rhino 3D techniques. Today I would like to talk about this heart shape ring. Heart has been symbol using in jewelry design in many different ways. Are you ready? Let's get started. We are going to start with the front view that build a diameter for 16, like most of my demonstration. And then we are going to find a heart on internet. You'll be surprised, it's much easier to trace the internet instead of try to build your own. That's because we have some visual things to follow up. So you can just look at the shape and pick the one that you like the most. I happen to like this clean one, and we're gonna alter it anyway, but I would like you to pick up one from Google and save into your hard drive or anywhere you can find. So once you have it, let's go back to the Rhino. Let's move on to the top view, and in Rhino 6 you can just type it picture. In Rhino 5, you might need to type picture frame instead. So we have this heart, and I'm going to put it somewhere over here. It doesn't matter the size at this point. We just need to know easier to trace it, and then we're going to move it back. So I'm just going to put approximately this size, and I'm going to trace the outline. So to trace it, I'm just going to use the red color. It's easier to see because I'm in the black background. So let's move to the red color. And when you try to trace, it's okay if they are not 100% follow the shape, because we can always turn on the control point and try to edit it. Okay. So now I have this one here, and I'm gonna turn on the control point and try to move it as close to the design as possible. So we try to move in all those points in and out a little bit, so that way they will follow the shape. You can also freehand to draw this heart if you want to, but I find out it's much easier to do it this way. Now we no longer need this one. The key things on this heart is you need to have the first point and the very last point is lined up. There are two ways to do it. I'm going to show you both ways. The first way is I'm going to pick up the end point on this point and make sure on this point and make sure my smart track is on. So I'm going to use the move tool and make sure that it's aligned with the first endpoint, so that way they will be aligned for sure, because the reason we do that is because we want to mirror it. Okay, so now they are there aligned. I can move it back there. The second way to do it is using the set point. So you type it set point on your command bar, and you want to pick up the point you want to set, which is those 2 points. You hit enter, and we want to align to X-axis at this situation. Then we click OK. Now you can move them to anywhere for those 2 points, and they will be aligned. I'm going to just snap it back to the first point there. So now if I do mirror, they will be exactly right in the middle. Okay, so this is my first heart. You can take a look on it. If you want to keep editing, you can do it at this point. So let's join it and move it to the top of our ring. Using the gumball, holding the shift and scale it down. All right. I also want to make sure this ring is aligned. The point is aligned right in the y-axis. So I'm going to use the align tool and align to the center, and I actually like to type it 0, so that way this one will be aligned to the center. I'm just gonna move it down a little bit, so that is where the ring shank is going to touch on both sides of the heart. Okay, the heart, you can be creative. The way I'm going to do is going to scale down a little bit, holding the use the gumball holding the shift key and hit the alt key. Right here you see the plus sign and you can release your mouse. Okay, now if I have the heart like this way, it's okay on the design, but I do like it more, be more interested. So I'm just gonna edit those control points, kind of bringing a little bit like this side, and kind of bring this one up a little bit too. You can be really, you can be creative to see, you know, how you like the heart is offset, so that way you won't end up with the same thickness. So I'm just gonna tweak a little bit here and there and to find the best proportion for my design. I'm going to fast forward a little bit here so you won't feel bored watching me doing this. Now we have this as well be the tool rail for us to sweep. We need to create in the profile. So I'm gonna coming over here. And let's go ahead to use the square, and then you want a round corner, and I do like a conic corner. So let's go ahead to use the 3 point. I'm gonna snap in here and here for our first 2 point, and let's go to the right view to see how high you want it to be. All right, so I get the first shape there. The second shape, I'm going to click on my perspective view again with those 3 point, and then want to make sure that they are not exactly the same height to be more interesting on the design. And I wanted to have them like something like this. Okay, so we got two conic corner square. Okay, let's try a sweep and see how they look. Going to the surface, we have sweep to rail. So this is your rail one, rail two, cross section. Okay, and make sure they are aligned perfectly, which in this way align to the bottom and the arrow of face interior. Okay, so you got this really crazy shape, but I don't want it to be so dramatic, so make sure you click maintain the height. So they will be the same height, just change the thickness. Okay, we also want to close the sweep, so they will do on the other side. Okay, now we click OK. Then we will get this shape. Okay, so let's go ahead to move this shape on top of our ring. All right, at this point, if you feel like this is like too big, you don't like it, you want to scale it down, you could do it at this point. All right, so I'm gonna hide this curve or it's not gonna bother us. All right, so we have this heart. Now with this heart, it doesn't follow the ring shank over there. So I do want it to follow the ring shank. The most easy way that I found is the simple command called bend. And I'm going to snap to the middle and kind of bend it to follow to the ring shank as close as possible. Okay, I'm gonna do one more time to do on the other side. All right. Now I have this, I can move it really close to the bottom. Okay, I'm gonna have it, actually you're going to see it, it's like a little bit lower than the black line, so I can trim it later to be a clean cut on the bottom. So I'm just gonna have it just a little bit lower. Okay, now we have done the top. You can see we have very nice heart over there. What we're going to do is to do the ring shank. The design that I have is you have a ring shank kind of going, kind of coming down and going to the halfway. So I'm gonna use the technique that I use a lot in many other model. Is I'm gonna put two little tag here. It's going to be right here. All right, I'm going to move it here a little bit. All right, so now you see I have two little straight line right there. Instead of draw the line, I'm going to use the blend tool. We are going to blend from here to here. Okay, so you get a really smooth blend there, and I might need to move it just a little bit to make it more to the shape that I want. Okay, make sure you don't want to join it because we are going to delete those two straight lines that we just drew earlier. Okay, so now we have this. We're just gonna simply using the pipe tool, and I'm going to pipe something really big there and something a little bit small over here. Okay, and then maybe you want to moving a little bit, move it down a little bit. It's really up to you how you like to do it. But I would like to take a look on the perspective and see how they look. And sometimes if it is hard to see, you can turn on the render view and see how they actually look over there. Okay, so you can tweak it into the way you like it to save time. I'm not gonna change in too much at this point. Okay, so now we need to create the rest of the ring shank. I'm going to extract the surface only on this one and delete that one. And to mirror this guy to the other side, I'm going to use the mirror, type it 0, and then I can mirror to the other side. The rest of it, we can use the sweep one, and we're gonna sweep from this surface edge to this surface edge and make sure they all align. Okay, so let's click OK. Now don't forget to join them so they will be solid. This is will be our ring. I'm going to go ahead to bowling unit those two first, and then we are going to go to the solid, and you have extruded planar curve straight, and let's go ahead to bowling unit those two. All right, so then we will have this very nice ring inside of a ring shank that is really clean. So now we finished this ring, the rest of it is put in a stone in there. I already pre-built this prong set over there. The similar idea to making this setting, you can go to my YouTube channel. One of the video that I have, actually the very first video, is how to build a bezel set pendant. It has a lot of detail talking about the stone's name and what is the proper way to build a prong and the bezel. So you can check on this video. It has a lot of good information for you to tell you how to actually build a setting for the stone. So I'm not going to spend time to tell you the same thing. Just go ahead and check in on that video. So once you have this, all you need to do is bowl this setting into the ring. Make sure that you're setting the bottom of the culet is not sticking out if your stone is a little bit bigger than what I have. I hope you like this video. Please like and comment and share this video. That is a great help for my channel, and that's the only way I can keep making free tutorial for you. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next Monday.